auto gas filling unit. Item number 10 is pellet press. This is pellet press. This pellet press is screw type pellet press. We open it. This is the pellet press cup which opens from the bottom. Its threads are important. Although it is all this thing made from stainless steel, but suppose it drops from the this much of height, then its threads may damage. So how to use this we will tell later on in the operation part of the instrument. So this pellet press cup in two part, we tight it with hand only. Again fix it here, keep sample here, then turn it clockwise so that it get compressed, and then remove it and take out. So this pellet press is used to make pellet of a sample. Generally we have this sample in powder form like benzoic acid, and when we make the pellet it becomes like this. So it becomes very hard. The purpose of making pellet in our instrument, it is required that we need complete combustion of the sample. So in the form of pellet, when the mass is all together, if any corner get fire or get flamed up, then there are more chances that every part will become burnt. And if it is in powder form, then while filling oxygen inside the bomb, some parts may scatter, and it is difficult that every part get combust. So to get complete combustion, we prefer to make pellet of the sample. So this is all about pellet press. Then the stirrer unit. See, this is the stirrer unit. If I show you opening it, see these blades are moving. This is a very robust, very heavy duty type pellet press, stirrer unit. If you keep it on for 4, 5, 6 hours continuously, then also there is no problem at all. It is tested for 8 hours for many days continuously. So, but main precautions you have to take. First of all, that this is a propeller that goes inside the water. So this propeller should not touch to anybody thing. If it is touching to something, then you may listen some sound. So if you do proper installation, then it may not touch to any part. The main purpose of this stirrer, that we have to measure the temperature in water. So before firing, we note down the water temperature, and then we fire the sample, keeping our sensor inside the water, and then we again monitor temperature rise. So the main purpose of this stirrer, that it make all the water column homogeneous temperature in all that chamber. Generally 2 liter of water is used. So this is stirrer unit. After that, electronic firing unit and digital Beckman thermometer with printer. Now this part is the this digital unit is called electronic firing unit and digital Beckman thermometer. This it is having with printer. So with printer models we keep this plate. It is for transportation purpose only, to save this printer. Once it has reached to the lab, you may remove this plate. This plate is only for safety of this printer part. It has nothing to do after transportation. Once the instrument is reached to your lab, there is no requirement of that. When we switch on, you may see that some reading will come, temperature reading will come. So it has two purposes. It is firing unit. It helps to burn the sample by pressing this fire button. The sample will burn. And secondly, it has a digital temperature indicator. This in model of this unit is written like 5A, 6 and 7. Generally the same unit is used for 3 models. For 5A, this printer is not there. For 6 and 7, the unit is same. So this is this unit. Now next part is connecting lead. these are the accessory box. This is the connecting lead. Item number 13 is the connecting lead. Open. This connecting lead is connected from back side of this unit. One red and black sockets are there from that portion. Red goes in red, black goes in black, and the other part goes on the this terminal of bomb. Any red and black in any part. So this is a connecting lead or electrical lead. The main purpose of this lead is to give path for the current to reach from a digital unit to the ignition wire. Now next accessory is the hook. This is the hook. This hook is used to lift this bomb. Like this. This is the bomb lifting hook. This one. Now item number 15 is crucible. This is SS crucible in which sample is kept. Bomb O-ring. These are the three number bomb O-rings. One number is fitted, already fitted inside the bomb, and three numbers are given in spares. Then stirrer belt. Similarly for stirrer, one number is given in the stirrer. It is tied here by opening this plate, which can easily open by opening this knob is there. So one is fitted and three are given in spares. Next part is valve body O-ring. This is smaller O-ring. It's called the valve body O-ring. It is also given here. This is the valve body where this is fitted. It is just tied with the thread. You have to remove this thread for using. It may not get displaced. That is why it is tied with the thread. So this is valve body O-ring. It's small. One is there. Three are given separate as a spare. Then stirrer belt, valve body O-ring. Ignition wire. Item number 19 is ignition wire. So one spool is there in which ignition wire is there. This ignition wire is a small, very thin wire which helps igniting the sample. Then shader valve. These are the valves. One is fitted inside the bomb. This at the center, NRV. This is the NRV valve, non-return valve, or shader valve. Shader is the name of the company, and this is the valve. This is very heavy duty valve used for this instrument. So it is called shader valve. So five pieces are given here as a spare. Cotton reel, this is cotton reel which helps in igniting the sample, cotton reel. Benzoic acid, this is the benzoic acid, its value is also written there. So it is used to standardize the bomb calorimeter. World over, benzoic acid is only used to standardize the bomb calorimeter. So we give this benzoic acid with a photocopy certificate of some testing laboratory also, which confirms its calorific value. Then gas releasing pin. So this is small pin, is a gas releasing pin, metallic pin. What happens when we do the complete test, then before opening this lid, we have to release this oxygen. For releasing this oxygen, this pin is there. You just touch this pin and slightly press this pin against this wall, and the oxygen will release. So this is a better way. This, by using this pin, the life of this wall will increase. So this is gas releasing pin, oxygen releasing pin. And the last part is a wall key. One wall key is there, it is a plus sign wall key. This wall key is used to replace this wall. Suppose there is any problem in the wall, then you may replace this wall. Five numbers are given in spare using this wall key. So these are the parts description of bomb calorimeter. All these parts I have focused for model RSB-7. Now I tell you for other models, this unit is not there. This auto gas unit comes with only RSB-7 model. For other models, the system of oxygen filling will be like this. Now see, here there are three tubes. One tube, it will insert with the oxygen cylinder. Oxygen comes through this tube through the pressure gauge, from pressure gauge to safety device, and then from safety device two SS bombs like this. So here the safety device, if suppose by chance operator does not know how much oxygen to fill inside the bomb, and if he opens the valve, so at particular, up to particular pressure, this will allow oxygen to fill inside the bomb. After that pressure, it will burst and oxygen get released from this point and helps this bomb to be in safer limits all the time. Oxygen in this bomb will remain in the safer limits. So oxygen filling system for model RSB 5, 5A and 6 is this type, and for RSB 7, this auto gas unit is there. So one basic difference in oxygen filling system, and second difference in the this digital unit. For our RSB 5 model, we are having this type of unit. In this unit, here it is written RSB 5. On the back side, if you see, all the arrangements are same. These are for oxygen, this electrical lead, and this is for stirrer. Supply, stirrer supply is given on the back side. And as far as the display is concerned, it is having two temperature. This is initial temperature, and this is temperaturized. On this mode only this instrument is used. So here you can see there are two places after decimal point, like 4.09. So here we, before firing the sample, we do it 0.00 manually. This is what to be done before firing manually in this unit. Secondly, it is two digits after decimal point, and third, end point is also to be noted down by the operator. And models above this, like 5A, this is 5 unit for 5A. Here you can see the display is three places after decimal point. So the resolution is 0.001. Here the resolution is 0.01. Second thing, it is microprocessor based. It has memory auto zero. Initially it does auto zero automatically. Second, endpoint is also detected automatically. Third, it will give the final result. And suppose operator is not there in the lab, so after a particular time, it will note down the reading, give a beep, and then store that value in the memory. But here in this case of RSB5, operator has to be there to note down the end point, what is the final temperature. And secondly, it will not give the direct calculation of the reading. It will only give you the temperature reading, and on that temperature reading, you have to calculate manually to find out calorific value of the sample. So this is our model RSB5. In model RSB5, this unit is given as the electronic firing unit with digital Bergman thermometer. In model RSB5A, this unit is given. It is microprocessor based, auto calculation, 0.001 temperature resolution with memory application. And in our next model RSB6, this unit is there. It is having printer also. The same unit as RSB5A plus printer is also installed. And in the next model RSB7, this unit remains same. It comes with the auto gas unit. So this is all about description of the digital bomb calorimeter. Thank you.